the only Asian in my old school in Tennessee had a spell us. For example, sweeping the award ceremonies because people automatically assumed I was the smartest in the room. However, those benefits came with a cost. When I first moved to Tennessee in third grade, people asked me, "Where are you from?" A pretty common question. But when I responded with Delaware, I got the astonishing response, "Is that in China?" uttered from not just one, but a handful of my classmates. Many would disregard this as childhood ignorance, but for me, it was one of the first exposures I had to the discrimination I faced as a result of societal ignorance. This societal ignorance soon developed into a more complex form of oversimplification. As I grew older, I realized that when approaching oversimplification, it is imperative that we first recognize what oversimplification is and what it entails. As Merriam-Webster defines it, oversimplification is to simplify to such an extent as to bring about distortion, misunderstanding, or error. And this can happen both consciously and subconsciously, which is why it is important that we recognize our natural predispositions and work to limit their effects. As we oversimplify, we become blind to the differences within groups, such as the types of oppression a group might face. And these specifics are crucial to identify when attempting reform, especially in areas of social justice. And when they fail to be identified, the reforms that we create and vote for become ineffective because they fail to address the root cause of the problem, instead fixing a distorted version. And this usually ends up creating more problems than those that existed originally, which is why it is imperative that we recognize the dangers of oversimplification in order to promote a greater appreciation for diversity and create an environment where we are able to create viable social justice reform. In a world full of constant stimuli, we oversimplify so that we can understand complex problems in complex situations. But what allows us to easily interpret the world around us can also cause our misinterpretation. Similarities between groups create a misconception that groups are related, which can lead to the assumption that struggles different groups face are the same. Oversimplification severely limits our ability of pattern perception, which allows us to differentiate between correlation and causation. A lack of pattern perception can lead to the misinterpretation of correlation as causation. A common example is the correlation between ice cream and murder. Almost all murderers have bought ice cream, but not all those who buy ice cream are murderers. And this concept can be applied to more prevalent social issues such as stereotypes. Many racial stereotypes imply a causal relationship when there is at best a weak correlation. This type of causal thinking can lead to the creation of ineffective social reform. Governments fail to address outsider problems and struggles effectively without doing more harm than good. And this can be exemplified by the general approach to racism. When people look to fix racism, they only look to solve one group's problems, usually whichever has been more prevalent in the media. Oversimplification not only leads to ineffective social reform, but it creates a competitive and distrusting environment between communities of people of color, because they believe that they must fight for the attention of media in order to get their issues addressed or even considered. And this creates an environment, and this creates a belief both among the communities and the general population that there is only one group, the oppressed. It generalizes all groups into one, ignoring that some may face more of a systemic discrimination, while others face more of a social injustice. Oversimplification not only takes place on an interracial racial scale, but it is also prevalent within races themselves. Take, for instance, the oversimplification of Asians. Many people view Asians as the same, or they disregard groups that are ethnically Asian because they don't look like other Asians. For example, I have met an astonishing amount of people who actively deny that Indians are Asian when India is literally in Asia. As someone who's ethnically Chinese, I've been told to speak Japan, or that someone isn't racist because they love the Korean dramas my country puts out. I mean, last time I checked, China was different than Korea or Japan, right? But when I go to correct them, the most common response I tend to receive is, "But it's basically the same thing." We need to slow down and realize that oversimplification is something that has existed in our society since prior to something that can be solved with one type of policy or within a presidential term. So when approaching this problem, it's imperative that we become more receptive to other people's stories so that we don't continually oversimplify and generalize. So if there's anything that you take from my speech today, I hope that it is to open your ears and listen to other people's experiences just as you have listened.